welcome to my world. My name is Ibrahim Mustafa, and I believe in you. I don't know who you are. I don't even know what you do, but I still believe in the possibility that you can change the world. Today, I'm going to share with you 5 tips for beginners who want to speak in public. So if you're a beginner, you want to speak in public, I want to share with you some 5 tips that can help you. If you're also a professional, this can help you to get more clients, to reach out to more audience, and to be able to communicate effectively. If you are new to this channel, subscribe, like, or send me a comment for coaching services. So let's move straight to the tips that I want to share with you. The first tip I want to share with you is, you need to believe in yourself. You may already have heard this from different people, but I want you to know that the first thing, or the first technique, or the first skill that you need to speak in public is to believe in yourself. If you don't believe in yourself, no one will believe in you. If you don't believe in yourself, you will walk into the room and you feel confused, you feel nervous, because you don't even believe in who you are, and the audience will never believe in you because you don't even show that in you. So believing in you is key. If you walk into any room, own the room, be the room, be in the moment, believe that you can make a difference, and use the power of your story to make a difference, because you believe in you, and because you believe in you, the audience will believe or start believing in you. Second tip I want to share with you is, make eye contact. Eye contact is key in speaking in public. So if you want to connect with your audience and you make a lasting impact or impression on them, you need to learn to make eye contact. Some people just underestimate this technique and they go ahead thinking that it's all about whatever they say. That is important. No, eye contact is very important in public speaking. So if you walk into a room and you can see speakers who do this, they walk into a room and they are just speaking, y'all. Oh, my name is Ibrahim Mustafa and I believe in you, I believe in... No, you don't believe in them. You speak into the thin air. But if you walk into the room and you start looking at them, my name is Ibrahim Mustafa, I believe in you, I believe in you, I believe in the power of your possibilities, you can make it possible, because I, looking at you, believe that you can make a difference. So with this, you are emotionally, psychologically, physically connecting with the audience because you are making eye contact with them, and this will help you. So if I walk into any room, my technique about eye contact is, I divide a room into 3, left, right, and middle. So I start with the middle, and I pick 2 or 3 people, look into their eyes for 3 seconds or 5 seconds, and I move to the right. I'm still doing the same presentation if I'm doing like to the general public, but I'm picking individuals and making eye contact with them. Then I'll do the same for all the wings. And once you do that, you pick people from the back, people in the middle, people in front, you look at them, you are connecting to the whole audience, and you can tell them what they need to know, and they will feel that this presentation was for them. Right, so the third one is that your body language is key. Third tip I want to share with you is body language. How do you use your gestures? Do you just throw them around? Do you just start running into the crowd, or you're just in the crowd? No. You need to make coordinated movements. If you are using your gestures, learn to use your gestures the way that suits you. Don't copy people. Sometimes you look at people to inform them about your gestures, but don't try to copy, because if you copy someone, the way your voice sounds and the way your hands move may be unique to you. So learn to find your rhythm. And the more you find your rhythm, the more you can use your gestures correctly. So if you also want to move around on stage, it's important that you do it coordinatedly. Don't just keep running. And I've seen people fall on stage because they were in a haste and they were introduced out of nervousness. They ran onto the stage and they fell down. Never do that. Take your time. Let the audience believe in you with the way you even appear. Don't put your hands this way in your presentation. Once you want to start and you do this, I'll just know that you are nervous, right? And don't put your hands in your pocket. So as part of the body language for today, don't do this. Don't put your hands in your pocket and stop touching your head like this. It's bad body language. Then the fourth one, the fourth tip I want to share with you is to practice. Practice and practice. There are a lot of ways you can practice your speaking. First of all, you can record yourself and listen to your voice. Delete it on your phone. Record, delete, like do that multiple times and you get start getting better. The third one, and the second way of practicing is you can practice with live audience. So if you have an event coming up, you can bring people, 2 or 3 or 10 people together and communicate with them. Practice with them, speak, present to them, for them to judge you. And sometimes you may have, if you're going to speak to like 2,000 audience, there's nothing wrong if you organize another seminar for like 200 or 100 and to use them to practice. And once you use them to practice, you can do more. So you can volunteer at events to practice your speaking. You can even ask questions to practice, right? You are at an event and there are a lot of people and you are afraid, you are lacking confidence. You get up, raise up your hand, ask a question. And in the process of asking the question, you can put in some few words just to present. So you can use that to practice. And you can also read aloud to practice. So there are different ways you can practice. Some will say go stand in front of the mirror and practice. Some will say like give you different advices. But pick what is best for you and use that and practice more. But before your presentation, make sure you practice. You are never an expert. Don't tell yourself that me, I've been doing this for the past 10 years. No, you need to still practice. Before you go there, your PowerPoint, you don't even have, you can't even download your own presentation. You don't even know where A is or B is and you get confused. So practice is key. There's no professional, there's no expert in public speaking when it comes to practicing. All the people I know, international speakers, local speakers, good speakers, they practice to speak. And the bad speakers don't even practice. They just feel like once I get on stage, I will figure it out. And they get on stage and they forget. So you need to practice. Practice is key. The final tip I want to share with you for today is the power of stories. Stories makes a difference. The more you share your stories with your audience, the more you can get them emotionally, physically. You can get them to take some course of action. You can get them inspired of the power of your stories. So learn to share your stories. Package your stories as products. As speakers, we sell words and stories. So the more you package your stories as products, you can be able to reach out to your audience effectively. But if you don't package the stories very well, I'm telling you, you are not going to make any impact. So the more you package your stories, the more you learn to share full stories, you can make a difference. Some people pick stories and they don't end their stories. So people don't even know the moral of the story, why the person was sharing the story. They will just pick it halfway, they'll forget and move to another story. Sometimes it happens to me. I'm just trying to let you know that learn to bring your stories on stage as packages. So the more you share your stories, the more you can reach out to your audience and impacting them positively. There are people in life who've been speaking like 10 years. When I want to coach people, if I give them the offer, they'll feel like, why? I've been speaking for the past 10 or 20 years. What can you teach me? I just tell them, I'm going to teach you how to tell your stories correctly. And once we finish the training or coaching, you realize that they've been leaving a lot of money or impact behind by not sharing good stories. So there are ways you can share your story. There are two ways that I recommend that you learn to share your stories. One is your personal stories. What have you gone through? What are your experiences? What have you seen in the past? How can that help your audience? That's one way of telling your stories. The second way is, other people's stories. I can pick the story of Bill Gates. I can pick the story of Mark Zuckerberg. I can pick a story of a product and share to the audience to buy that product. And once I'm doing that, I'm sharing the story of that product, and that falls under other people's stories. So learn to share your stories well, and learn to share other people's stories well. Because the more you do that, and if you do that effectively, your audience will buy into your stories and they will buy your products and services. Thank you for making time. Thank you for believing in me. Thank you for being here. Thank you for being present. And thank you for making this possible. I believe in you, and I believe that you subscribe, you like, and you even join my one-on-one coaching services. Thank you for your time. You are a champion. Never give up. I believe in you.